This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about piecewise defined functions. So a piecewise defined function is a function which is broken down into two or more parts or pieces. And for each of those pieces, we're going to have a different rule or a different formula. So this example, for instance, says that for f of x is going to equal negative x plus 1 whenever x is less than 2. That's what this first line over here tells me. But it also says that f of x is going to equal the square root of x minus 2 whenever x is greater than or equal to 2. So in other words, for two different parts of the graph, I'm going to have two different sets of instructions. Any part of the graph where x is less than 2 will follow this first set of instructions that says make f of x equal to negative x plus 1 whenever x is equal to or greater than 2. I'll use the second set of instructions, which says I should make f of x equal to the square root of x minus 2. Okay, so very often when you're working with piecewise defined functions, you may be given an assignment to fill in a table of values. So we'll make a table here. We'll make one row for x values and another row for f of x. That'd be the same as y. And let's find the f of x values for, let's say, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so starting with x equaling negative 1, let's see. When x is equal to negative 1, then x is less than 2. So I'm going to use this first line here, the first set of instructions. That tells me to take the x, which is negative 1, and plug it into this, negative x plus 1. So I want negative, negative 1, that's positive 1, plus 1. So that's going to equal 2. So when x is negative 1, f of x, or y, is going to equal 2. When x is 0, since 0 is also less than 2, I'll still use these first instructions. I'll plug a 0 in instead of the x. I'll have negative 0, which is just 0, plus 1. So when x is 0, f of x, or y, is going to equal 1. When x is 1, that's still less than 2, so I'm still using that first line. I'll have negative 1 plus 1, and that equals 0. Now when x is 2, I've got to go down to the second set of instructions, the second rule, because I use that whenever x is greater than or equal to 2, and my x is 2. So this tells me to plug an x into the square root of x minus 2, or to plug the 2 into the square root of x minus 2. So that's going to be the square root of 2 minus 2, which is 0. So the square root of 0, the square root of 0 is 0. The last number I have is 3. 3 is greater than 2, so I'm using the square root part. I want the square root of 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2 is 1, and the square root of 1 is 1. Okay, so there's my table of values for x and f of x. Remember, f of x is the same as y. So given this table of values, I can graph this function as well. So I'll draw a rough graph. I'll put in some x values, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, 1, 2, 3. And I'll put in some y values, 1, 2, 3, and maybe a negative 1. And let's plot this. So I'm going to have a point where x is negative 1 and f of x, or y, is 2. So that's negative 1, comma 2. Negative 1, comma 2 will be here. Then I'll have another point at 0, comma 1. That's on the y-axis. I'll have a point at 1, comma 0. That's on the x-axis. Now, these three points all came from that first part of the function, which was a linear equation, f of x equals negative x plus 1. So that means these points are going to lie in a straight line, and I could connect them. And I could continue that straight line up to, going to the right, up to, but not including the place where x equals 2. So I'll put an open circle at the end of that. So that takes care of those first three points. Now let's take this point 2 comma 0. So I'm going to have 2 comma 0, that's on the x-axis. And then I want a point 3 comma 1, that's going to be over here. Now that was part of that square root function, or the square root part of the function. So since a square root function is a curve that looks like this, I can just kind of continue that curve. Okay, so basically what I've done is I've taken the piecewise defined function, I've filled in some values in a table for x and f of x, and then I can use those values to plot some points on a graph and connect the lines. I'll be able to connect the lines fairly well if I remember what kind of function each part of the piecewise defined function is. The first part was a linear function, so I was able to connect those in a straight line. The second part was a square root function, so I drew a smooth curve for the square root part of it. Okay, that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.